NFT music is going to shake up the music industry. It is going to take the power away from the record labels and put the power back into the hands of the musicians. Electronic music producer Blau sold a collection of limited edition NFTs for $3.6 million, and Grammy-winning producer Illmind auctioned the rights to new samples as an NFT. And this is the NFT. This is the tweet. It is this picture, 30 seconds with music. I can go ahead and listen to it for free. Yet he auctioned it off, and someone actually paid $6,000 for it. And I know what you guys are thinking. Why would anyone pay for these NFTs when you can get them for free? So in this video, I am going to tell you exactly why, and we are going to break it down. And if that sounds good, make sure to hit the like button. And with that being said, let's get into the content. Welcome aboard the Bitcoin Express. My name is Chase. Let's get to it. First, a quick summary of what NFTs are. NFT stands for non-fungible token. These are digital items that are rare. They are non-fungible, making them unique. And over the last year, we have seen that NFT art and NFT in-game collectibles have been selling for hundreds of thousands of dollars. And specifically, when it comes to NFT art, we are not necessarily paying for what is on the picture. We are paying for the reputation. If we have an NFT created by Beeple, it can be worth millions of dollars. But if we have the same exact image created by a different artist that is not Beeple, it will have very little value. So when we're talking about the NFT music art world, it shares a lot of similarities. So when it comes to NFT music, we have musicians out here that are selling samples of their song. And this is going to shake up the music industry for a few reasons. Non-fungible tokens are being used to explore a new business model that puts music makers back in control of sales and copyright issues and takes the power away from the record labels. And in this case of Grammy-winning producer Illmind, he released what he calls the first ever NFT-backed sample loop melody pack. And it also comes with royalty-free guarantee and a contract that gives the NFT owner rights to use the audio files for their own purpose. So similar to NFT art, where you need a reputation, right now we are seeing in the NFT music space, you have to build a reputation as well. So this artist here, Illmind, he has produced tracks for several best-selling hip-hop artists, including Kanye West, Dr. Dre, and 50 Cent. And in 2018, he won a Grammy Award for his production of Everything Is Love by Beyoncé and Jay-Z. So the first part to this is you are selling pretty much a collectible. And I know at first glance, this is hard to understand, but I think the easiest way or the best way to comprehend this is compare it to vinyl records. There was a Wu-Tang Clan vinyl record that sold for $2 million. The Beatles, vinyl record, $790,000. Elvis Presley, $300,000. These are pieces of music we can get for free. We can go on Apple Music and listen for free. So we can see in this case, people are paying for a collectible. So when it comes to NFT music, this will be the first step, but this is only a fraction. This is not why it's going to shake up the music industry. The reason that this is going to shake up the music industry is because these NFT music samples or these NFT music rights will come with added utility. And when it comes to the musician Blau, the one that we use in the intro, he announced that the top bidder of his upcoming NFT auction will be offered the chance to collaborate with him on a new track. This is very big. Imagine in the future, musicians such as Drake or other popular musicians say, whoever wins this NFT will be featured in my song. Whoever wins this NFT, I'll mention their name in my song. Whoever wins this NFT, I will send them a signed CD, or now we don't have CDs anymore, a signed shirt, or I'm gonna send them some gift basket. The point here is you can get creative, and musicians are very creative by nature. And when it comes to NFTs, they can add utility to it. There is no limit to what they can do. Linkin Park rapper Mike Shinoda auctioned off a clip of an upcoming song in an NFT form. And here is the tweet from the rapper himself. And he said, whoever wins this NFT tomorrow will be receiving a physical real life print of the art signed by the rapper himself. There is no limit to what an artist can do. They can get as creative as they want. So we can see so far there are two use cases here. The first one is a collectible. And the second one is that you can add utility to the token. But the third use case, maybe the biggest one, is that musicians and artists will want to use NFTs to take back power. This is a tweet from Jane Zhu, and she put it perfectly. She stated a use case that is genuinely better than the way it's currently done. Creators of the samples are paid directly instead of through some sample label. We can see there are three main use cases here. Number one, a collectible. Number two, added utility. And number three, taking power back from the record labels and giving it to the musicians. Now, the most important part of creating NFT music, if you're a musician yourself and you wanted to add some of these NFTs and add utility, is you always have to build up that reputation first. This is very similar to NFT art. If you are a talented artist, but no one knows about you, it's gonna be a little difficult for you to break through into the NFT space. You'll have to work on your reputation. Sometimes that could take a year, 2 years, 5 years, 10 years. So in the NFT music world as well, we can see that with famous musicians such as Blau or Illmind, instant access when they create these NFT music samples. But if you are an aspiring musician yourself, obviously you can get in on this as early as possible, but also make sure to work on your reputation, whatever that is. That could be on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, whatever it is that you need to do. Now, when you're ready, there is no difference in uploading NFT music than there is with NFT art or NFT collectibles. You can go to a site like mintable.app or rarible.com. And when you go ahead and you create an NFT, you mint an NFT, you can choose a file. You can choose MP4, MP3, PNG, GIF. So anything you have, if you have a music sample, you can upload an MP3. If maybe you have a picture with music, just like Illmind did with his NFT, then same thing, you can upload an MP4. What's crazy about all of this is that there is no limit. There is so much creativity to this whole space, which is perfect for musicians who are creative by nature. This is going to shake up the music industry. It is going to take power away from the record labels and put it right back into the hands of the musicians. I hope that you learned a lot in this video. Leave a like, leave your comments. I wanna know your thoughts. Subscribe to the channel. Thank you for listening, and I'll see you next time.